My vision is that the national parks are places that people really care about, they relate to, they connect to. We are one of the largest informal education institutions in the country. So we have a responsibility with these places to help the public understand complex issues. And climate change is probably one of the most complex issues we have facing us as a nation, as a world.
Partnered with Colorado State University on a climate change education project that did a lot of visitor and employee research. Very interesting that many of the interpreters felt that they didn't want to burden the public with information about climate change, that the public wasn't as interested in it as they themselves were. Well, the reality is that the visitor surveys showed that the visiting public is quite concerned about climate change, much more so than the interpreters thought, and that they are looking to us for information and they do want to learn it.
National parks have been set aside, you know, for their integrity, and we are a living laboratory. So again, we can provide not only a baseline in terms of how things have been in the past, sort of that historical perspective, if we've got the data to support that, but then we can also serve as a long-term monitoring laboratory so we can watch those changes.
I want people to understand that it affects them in their everyday life. It affects them also in preserving the heritage that we share and that they treasure, and that regardless of what their belief is about the genesis of climate change, that changing patterns, whether it be increased flooding or inundation of barrier islands, that there's a loss there.
And then we can also use parks as an education tool to help educate the public, to talk about what we're doing, how the climate is changing, how we're addressing a changing climate, and how that can affect them and what they can either do or not do to help them adapt to climate change.
National parks and equivalent reserves, protected areas around the world, have the opportunity to engage the public in deepening their understanding about the challenges of climate change, about what opportunities there are to make a difference now.
And I think that we have to be intentional about it, and we have to learn the research, and we have to have interpreters that know how to help people become more scientifically literate. Science literacy to me is more than just knowledge of the facts. It's also knowledge of how the scientific process works and thinking about how scientists do inquiry and question and learning to ask questions yourself. People want to be involved, they want to do things. And that actually we used to think, well, we tell them information and they're going to get aware about it and then they're going to want to do something. Well, actually flip that around, it's the other way around, and this goes for kids in the classroom, kids outside the classroom, adults in the field, everybody wants to do something. Get them engaged, teach them how the scientists are collecting the data, show them how the data has changed over time, help them identify where a plant was growing before and now let's show them where it's growing now. That leads people to ask their own questions and to start to learn to do inquiry, and then you can engage them and enhance their ability to do that. And I think the role of interpreters is becoming more and more important for park employees as well. We are the translators of the science. We're the ones who have to learn it and be able to explain it in ways that it can be applied for management decisions.
We can look at climate change as an interdisciplinary research issue, and we can make sure that when we're looking at a problem, whether it be animal migration or pest management or changing precip patterns, that we're looking at it from multidisciplinary perspectives.
Form an interdisciplinary climate change learning group at your park. You know, involve some facilities folks and some natural and some cultural resources folks, because we realize now that climate change is having just as big an impact on our cultural resources as it is on our natural resources. So just if you're in a cultural park, don't think this doesn't apply to you.
We've been very successful historically in taking something like fire, which we had built great opposition to through our work and the work of other land management agencies, and changed the public's opinion about that. I think we can do the same thing with climate change.
I want to send a message to all the interpreters out there. You know, you've got the power. You've got the power to help people learn science, learn scientific method, help people become curious, and help people be able to evaluate information so they can make their own decisions. Say to yourself, you know, I actually have some power here, and I have some responsibility here, and I can make a difference. And so embrace that, and then live that in the way that you do your work.
My vision is that the parks step up to this responsibility, that we use the places that people care about to get them more knowledgeable, and also to see that we, the National Park Service, are stepping up to that responsibility ourselves, both in terms of mitigation, our Green Parks Plan, our adaptation strategy, the acquisition of new science, the long-term monitoring, and we're putting it all not only on your shoulders as the American public, but on our shoulders as well. You know, climate change is a choice, and it's only going to be acted upon with public understanding, and parks have a unique role in that. We are taking on that responsibility and taking action. And if we make those actions highly visible, then the public may themselves be inspired to take action on their own.